Welcome to On Chemistry. Always do your best. Now, let us see about Wagner Meerwein rearrangement. This is a very basic rearrangement in organic chemistry everyone should know. We will study basics and 10 best examples. Stay tuned. What is inside this video? Inside this video, first we will see what is rearrangement, particularly Wagner Meerwein rearrangement. Then we will see the mechanism. Then we will learn from example. I provided 10 best examples. I given the system with ring strand and ring opening, ring contraction, consecutive rearrangement and aromatization. We will see one by one. At first, let us see what is rearrangement. There are the many reactions are possible in chemistry. Rearrangement like you are juggling the atoms. Juggling means you are replacing atom inside the molecule without change in the structure, just atoms are switched to each other. So ABC start mean ACP. This is the rearrangement. You should know rearrangement means like moving a molecule. It is not mere isomerization. It involves breaking and forming of bonds. Before we get into that, we will see what is cation. In cation, tertiary cation is stable. Why tertiary cation is stable? Because it attached with CH3, which is the electron donating group, which has plus inductive effect. So it donates the electron and neutralizes the charge. So it stabilizes the positive ion. So more the methyl group, more the stability. Hence, tertiary attached with 3 carbon, tertiary is stable, then secondary, then primary, at last methyl. So tertiary system is more stable. Always it's tried to form as an intermediate in any reaction. Now let us see what is Wagner Meerwein rearrangement. Wagner Meerwein rearrangement means shifting of methyl group or hydrogen during the cation formation. Even though cation is formed, always the intermediate try to convert it into tertiary. So the tertiary conversion happens, that's why groups are shifting. Here is on the alkyl bromide, where leaving a bromide leads to cation, that cation is primary. To make it a tertiary, the methyl group moves and the cation formed in the tertiary cation. So the rearrangement occurs because the methyl group switched, rearranged. So it is a Wagner Meerwein rearrangement. What is the driving force for the reaction? Stable tertiary cation. So we always say rearrangement. So which group will migrate or which group will move? There can be 3 possibilities. One is hydride shift, hydrogen shifts. The first one is primary cation. The hydrogen shifts and forms the tertiary cation. The methyl also can shift. Second example shows the methyl shifts and converted into primary to tertiary. At last the methylene group or ring methyl group. Here the secondary cation is formed, but the ring strand again switch itself to form the same secondary cation without ring strand. So there are 3 possibilities: hydride shift, methyl shift and methylene shift. The important facts you should know. The migratory aptitude means which will move faster. So hydrogen move very easily, then phenyl, then methyl. This is all because of the stability of those groups, that's why. Then electron rich species move first. Since it is a cation involved, so electron rich species move and stabilize the cation. Then the ring strain also play the role. The smaller rings have very high strain, so the ring will open and the methylene shift happen. So propane has higher, pentane is little less, the cyclohexane is much more stable. Here the catalyst can be Bronsted acid like HCl and H2SO4, or it can be Lewis acid, aluminum chloride, silver oxide or ferric chloride. Since the cation formation is there, the polar solvents promote it. Moreover, you should know the competition between elimination and substitution reactions also. So these are the important facts you should know. Let us start from the example. The first example is like hydroxyl group in the bicyclic system. Here bicyclic system attached with alcohol, the product converted into aldehyde, but methyl group is shifted here. How you explain? Reason is Wagner Meerwein rearrangement. Let us start from the starting material, which is alcohol. Then we use the Brønsted acid, HCl, so H plus donation will be there. Then the water elimination, so H2O will leave. Then the cation formation is there. Since it is a secondary cation, it will be little bit unstable. So the methyl group shifted and form a tertiary cation there. So the rearrangement occurs to create the stability of stable tertiary cation. So again the chlorine will attack, the same compound will form as expected. So you should know stable tertiary cation formation is driving force. Here is the second example with ring expansion. Here also a cyclic system where alcohol is outside, but the product will be 5 member cyclic system, chlorine is attached. How you explain? You have to use Wagner Meerwein rearrangement. What will happen? Same reaction mechanism, H plus will attack, water will eliminate, cation formation will be there. So what really happened is it's already tertiary cation formation, but the ring strain of tertiary butyl is very high. That's why it promotes to 5 member ring and form the secondary cation. Even though the argument of cation is different here, but the stability driven to 5 member ring. So methylene shift will happen, 5 member ring will occur. So you should know ring expansion is always possible. Then the third and attractive example is like consecutive Wagner Meerwein rearrangement. Here the flower like cyclopropyl structure converted into flower like cyclobutyl structure. How it's happening? Here the same story of rearrangement will happen. So the first step will be elimination of H2O, so cation formation is there. Since the ring strain is very high, the group become 3 member to 4 member. So again cation formation will be there in the methylene mobilized carbon, so positive charge is there. Next to propyl group attack, so 4 member ring will form. Similarly all the propyl group converted into butyl groups. At last the positive charge in 1 butyl, the chlorine will attack, end product will form. Here you have to know consecutive rearrangement to create the stable cation. This example is attractive, you should know. Then the fourth example. So wherever the cation formation, there will be a rearrangement. Here the exocyclic double bond is there in the cyclopentyl system, but the product will be 6 member. So how you account it? First step is attack of H+. It's a Markovnik of addition. So H plus attacks on the end, so positive charge on secondary system. Even though it's secondary, ring strain is there. So what will happen? To relieve the ring strain, the methylene group move and form the cation there. So 6 member system will form. Again the hydride shift will be there. Why? Because to create the stable tertiary cation. So at last the ring attached bromine will be there. So the final product will be cyclo methyl bromide. Here there are two possibilities. Hydrogen shift can occur before expansion or after the expansion. So after the expansion will be effective, because then only you are reducing the ring strain. Otherwise you are retaining the ring strain. If you wish, you redraw and dry it, you will get the same one. So here we have to relieve the ring strain. Then the next and complicated example, which is kind of camper system where the alkali group is there, then the methylated system converted into the product, which is chloride. So how it is formed? We will write the same mechanism there. HCl attacks, water eliminates, then the cation formation. Here hydride shift occurs yearly, so hydride shift occurs, stable cation forming, which is tertiary cation. To relieve the ring strain, the methyl group will shift there and form the cation again. So the chlorine will attack the cation and form the final product. Here also you have to decide hydrogen shift will be there first or second. You try yourself, this is the best possible way to create the or reduce the ring strain. So this is the best possible mechanism to reduce the ring strain. You can try the other way, but ring strain will be preserved there, not released. So this is the best mechanism to release the ring strain. Then the next interesting example, where aromaticity driven reaction. So here the starting material, which is a kind of naphthalene fused system, CH2OH is there. There are the three possibilities: just the substitution of OH to Cl, or the ring opening which is Br attached, or naphthalene system. What will be there? We will write the mechanism and find out. So first step is, as usual, cation formation. Then what really happened is the methylene group migrates and form the cation again. So methylene group formed, cation formed. So what is the next step? Addition of chlorine also there, but here the new thing, if you eliminate the hydrogen, aromaticity will be there. So aromaticity is a strong stabilizing factor for the molecule. So elimination here rather than the substitution. So hydrogen eliminated, anthracene will be formed. Then the seventh example. Here is the tricky one. You have the alcoholic group, but very much different product observed. Let us see why. We start from same OH, then the OH elimination, then the cation formation. So the cation is there. So what really happened? The cation should be stabilized. So secondary cation should be converted into tertiary cation. So how you can form the tertiary cation? You cannot form in the bridge. So what will happen? Really the bridge will move and form the cation above the molecule. Here you see third carbon has the cation. So the structure is really fluctuated there. So you have to redraw the structure to have the correct one. So there are the six member ring is there, one carbon above is there. So we redraw the molecule, observe the orange circle. Orange circle is same in the both the molecule and see the numbers. So you redraw the molecule, again the cation formation is there, you attack with chlorine and you got the final product. Why the movement of particular methylene is happened? Because that methylene group is exactly antiperpendicular to the cation, that's why it moves. Since there are the methyl group on above the bridge, this group is nearby as well as opposite to each other. That's why that methyl groups move and the product formation is observed. This is very tricky. You have to be master of writing bicyclic system. The next example also interesting one. You start from 5 to 4 member ring, converted into 2 5 member ring. So how it is possible? The same thing. Here starting material is carbonyl, you are attacking with H+, which is acid. So the H+, you attack on the oxygen, which is electronegative one. The product is cation there. So the cation should be relieved because the ring strain is there. So the ring strain forces the structure to be 5 member. So 5 member ring will be there. But the cation cannot neutralize itself, right? No other way cation can be eliminated. So the ring again have to contract to create the positive charge near the carbon. So the positive charge then converted into carbonyl. Here only the stability forces the structure to be 5 member, not the cation formation. So it is the only way you can neutralize the positive charge. Then the ninth example, which is also flower kind of architecture, where 3 OH groups are there and pentane systems also there. The product will be completely aromatized one. So how we explain it? We'll write it like same. First step is attack of H+, cation formation. So the ring strain relieved there. So how the positive charge will be eliminated? So there will be elimination reaction, H+ elimination. So the product will be double bond there. Again the same OH will be attacked by H+. Again the double bond formation. Similarly, you keep on going, you are getting the aromatic structure at the center. Here you should know there is no substitution, only elimination happened. Then the 10th example, which is also you can call it as exception. Here that 3 member ring will be there. What will be the product? 3 member or 4 member. Here cyclopropyl system, H plus attacks. So the product will be CH2 plus. So what will really happen? Alcohol formation will happen or not. But here there will be no 4 member ring alcohol formation. Only 3 member ring alcohol formation. Why? Because the cation of the cyclopropyl system has exceptional stability because of perpendicular p orbital. Normally p orbital of alkane is tetrahedral. Since it's supposed to be in trigonal form, all orbitals are perpendicular. So the orbitals are well stabilized by 3-step resonance. So this structure is extremely stable. There is no rearrangement. So this is the only exception in the Wagner Meerwein rearrangement. That's all from me today. I hope it was useful. Thanks for watching. If you have any suggestion, comment below.